In our previous modules, we have discussed about some fundamental and interesting properties of likelihood ratio test. In our today's discussion, we will discuss some further properties of an LRT or the likelihood ratio criterion. Majority of them deals with the asymptotic properties of an LRT or likelihood ratio criteria. These properties are very useful in various test situations due to wide applicability of likelihood ratio tests. So, today we will discuss about some further properties of LRT. We will start with the first property, that is, LRT may be worthless. Let us consider the following example, which is appropriate in this context. Suppose P theta equal to 0 at x, that is PMF of the random variable x at the point small x under theta equal to 0 is equal to alpha if x equal to 0, equal to half minus alpha if x equal to plus minus 1, equal to alpha by 2 if x equal to plus minus 2 and equal to 0 otherwise. Similarly, we define the PMF of x for all theta belonging to the open interval 0 to 1 closed, and this PMF is equal to 1 minus c by 1 minus alpha times alpha if x equal to 0, equal to 1 minus c by 1 minus alpha times half minus alpha if x equal to plus minus 1, equal to c theta if x equal to 2, provided 0 less than alpha less than half, and equal to c into 1 minus theta if x equal to minus 2, provided alpha by 2 minus alpha less than c less than alpha, and equal to 0 otherwise. Suppose we have to test the null hypothesis h theta equal to 0 against the alternative hypothesis k theta greater than 0. Now, the likelihood ratio criteria will be lambda x equal to capital Lx at theta equal to 0 divided by supremum of capital Lx theta supremum over all theta belonging to the closed interval 0 to 1. This implies lambda at x equal to 0 is equal to alpha divided by maximum of alpha and 1 minus c by 1 minus alpha times alpha. Now, it is given that c is less than alpha. That means 1 minus c is greater than 1 minus alpha, or 1 minus c by 1 minus alpha is greater than 1. And hence, 1 minus c by 1 minus alpha times alpha is greater than alpha. As a result, lambda 0 equal to alpha by 1 minus c by 1 minus alpha times alpha on simplification, which becomes 1 minus alpha by 1 minus c. With the similar way, we can get that lambda 1 equal to half minus alpha by maximum of half minus alpha and 1 minus c by 1 minus alpha times half minus alpha, and that becomes again 1 minus alpha by 1 minus c, which is equal to lambda at x equal to minus 1. In the same way, lambda 2 equal to alpha by 2 divided by supremum of alpha by 2 and supremum of c theta for all theta greater than 0 less than equal to 1. Now, supremum of c theta for all theta greater than 0 less than equal to 1 is actually c, and therefore lambda 2 equal to alpha by 2 divided by supremum of alpha by 2 and c. Again, we are given that alpha by 2 minus alpha is less than c, which implies 2 minus alpha by alpha is greater than 1 by c, or 2 by alpha minus 1 is greater than 1 by c. That means 2 by alpha should definitely be greater than 1 by c, or alpha by 2 is less than c. As a result of fact, lambda 2 equal to alpha by 2 divided by c, that is alpha by twice c. Similarly, lambda at x equal to minus 2 equal to alpha by 2 divided by supremum of alpha by 2 and supremum of c into 1 minus theta for all theta greater than 0 less than equal to 1. And on a similar simplification, we get this is again equal to alpha by twice c. Again, it is given that alpha by 2 minus alpha less than c, which implies 2 by alpha minus 1 greater than 1 by c, that is 2 by alpha minus 2 is greater than 1 by c minus 1, and that is nothing but 1 minus c by c. So we get twice 1 minus alpha by alpha is greater than 1 minus c by c, which is equivalent to saying 1 minus alpha by 1 minus c is greater than alpha by twice c. Hence, the likelihood ratio test is defined as lambda x less than d, which is equivalent to saying lambda x less than equal to alpha by twice c. Because lambda x has only two positive finite values, 1 minus alpha by 1 minus c and alpha by twice c. And among them, the smaller one is alpha by twice c. But lambda x less than equal to alpha by twice c implies an implied by lambda x equal to alpha by twice c, and which is equivalent to saying x equal to plus minus 2. So the critical region of the likelihood ratio test is here x plus minus 2. Regarding the size of the test, we have probability that capital X equal to plus minus 2 under theta equal to 0. And from the given information, it is nothing but twice alpha by 2, that is equal to alpha. So size of the test is alpha. Now power function of the test is probability under theta X equal to plus minus 2, that is equal to c theta plus c into 1 minus theta, that is equal to c for all theta greater than 0. But it is given that c is less than alpha. So what we got from power function? We got that power function equal to c, and that is less than alpha. So in this example, the power is less than equal to size. So this means the LR test considered here is biased. Now define a test function, say phi star x is equal to alpha, that is a constant for all x. Now clearly this is a trivial size alpha test. So the power function of this test is expectation of phi star x under theta, and that is again alpha for all theta greater than equal to 0. So what it means? It means that phi star, even being a trivial test, is unbiased and is uniformly more powerful than the above LR test. So naturally this means the above LR test is practically worthless. Now we will consider the large sample or asymptotic properties of an LRT. Consider the following theorems. Theorem under single parameter case. Consider the problem of testing a null hypothesis H, which says that theta equal to theta naught, against the alternative hypothesis K, which says that theta not equal to theta naught. Under the assumption of theorem 3, minus twice log of lambda x curl converges in distribution to chi square 1 under null hypothesis. So this was the statement of theorem under single parameter case. Proof of the above theorem under single parameter case. By definition, we know the likelihood ratio criteria lambda x squared equal to capital L theta naught by capital L at theta n hat, where capital L denotes likelihood function and theta n hat denotes the maximum likelihood estimator of theta. Therefore, log of lambda x curl equal to small l of theta naught minus small l at theta n hat, where small l theta denotes the log likelihood function of theta. Again, expanding small l theta naught with respect to theta n hat by Taylor's expansion, we get small l theta naught is approximately equal to small l at theta n hat plus theta naught minus theta n hat times small l prime theta n hat plus theta n hat minus theta naught square by 2 factorial times l double prime theta n hat. This is same as small l theta n hat minus small l theta naught is approximately equal to theta n hat minus theta naught square by 2 times minus small l double prime theta n hat, because small l prime theta n hat vanishes as theta n hat is the maximum likelihood estimator. Moreover, minus 1 by n times small l double prime theta n hat, which is equal to 1 by n summation I from 1 to n times minus del square del theta square f theta xi at theta equal to theta n hat, which is also known as observed Fisher's information, is asymptotically equal to I theta n hat, where I denotes Fisher's information. This implies twice small l theta n hat minus small l theta naught is asymptotically equivalent to root n times theta n hat minus theta naught whole square times I at theta n hat. Therefore, minus twice log of lambda x curl, which is equal to twice small l theta n hat minus small l theta naught, is asymptotically equivalent to root n times theta n hat minus theta naught whole square times I at theta n hat. Moreover, we know from asymptotic distribution of MLE that root n times theta n hat minus theta naught converges in distribution to normal with mean 0 and variance 1 by I theta naught. And also we know I at theta n hat converges to I at theta naught under H. As a result, we get root n times theta n hat minus theta naught into root over I function at theta n hat converges in distribution to normal 0, 1 under H. Hence the theorem. Consider another theorem, which is a theorem based on multiparameter case. Suppose we have to test the null hypothesis H, which says that the vector theta curl equal to theta naught curl against the alternative hypothesis K, which says that the vector theta curl is not equal to the vector theta naught curl. Then under the assumption of theorem 4, minus twice log of lambda x curl converges in distribution to chi square distribution with s degrees of freedom under H. So this was the statement of the theorem under multiparameter case. Obviously here the parameter vector theta curl is an S component vector. Now just like the earlier proof, here also we can prove this theorem using asymptotic multivariate normality of the vector valued MLE theta n hat curl of the S component parameter vector theta curl. In the context of asymptotic distribution, let us consider the following note, which gets several applications in testing of hypothesis. To test the null hypothesis H, which says that theta I is equal to the function gi of beta 1, beta 2, beta r for all I from 1 to s, provided r is less than s and the parameter beta 1, beta 2, beta r being unknown. Then under this hypothesis setup, minus twice log of lambda x curl converges in distribution to chi square distribution with s minus r degrees of freedom under the null hypothesis H, where s minus r denotes the number of parameters becoming specified by the specification of null hypothesis. As a support of the above note, we can discuss the following applications. Application 1. Let x1, x2, xn follow IID normal mu sigma square. Suppose we had to test the null hypothesis H mu equal to 0 versus alternative hypothesis K mu not equal to 0. Here the parameters are mu and sigma square, that is S equal to 2 here. Sigma remains unknown all through, that is R equal to 1. So here S minus R equal to 2 minus 1, that is 1, and as a result minus twice log of lambda x curl converges in distribution to chi square with 1 degree of freedom under H. As a second application, let x1 curl, x2 curl, xn curl follow IID p-variate normal with mean vector mu curl and dispersion matrix sigma. Obviously, mu curl is a p-component parameter vector and sigma is a p cross p symmetric PD matrix. Suppose we have to test the null hypothesis H sigma equal to small sigma square times identity matrix IP against the alternative hypothesis K, which says that sigma not equal to small sigma square times identity matrix IP. This typical testing is known as sphericity test. Here the number of parameters in general is S, which is equal to P parameters involved in mu curl and P into P plus 1 by 2 distinct parameters involved in sigma. So S equal to P plus P into P plus 1 by 2. Also the number of unknown parameters, that is R, is equal to P plus 1, where P is the number of parameters involved in mu and 1 for the unknown parameter small sigma square. So as a result, the number of parameters specified by the null hypothesis H equal to S minus R equal to P into P plus 1 by 2 minus 1. This implies minus twice log of lambda x curl here converges in distribution to chi square distribution with degrees of freedom P into P plus 1 by 2 minus 1 under null hypothesis H. Now we will consider consistency of an LRT. Let us consider the problem of testing the null hypothesis H, which says that theta belongs to the parameter space omega H, against the alternative hypothesis K saying that theta belongs to the parameter space omega K, which is again a subset of unconditional parameter space omega minus omega H. Naturally, the likelihood ratio criteria will be here lambda x curl equal to capital L x curl under theta H hat by capital L x curl under theta hat, where theta hat denotes the maximum likelihood estimator of theta under omega and theta H hat denotes the same under omega H. Suppose theta H hat converges to theta in probability, where theta belongs to omega H under omega H, and suppose theta hat converges to theta in probability which belongs to omega H union omega K under omega. Let the likelihood ratio test be lambda x curl less than Cn alpha, where the critical point Cn alpha is such that the size of the test is alpha, that is supremum of probability under theta lambda x curl less than Cn alpha, where supremized over all theta belonging to omega H is equal to alpha. Now under theta belonging to omega H, lambda x curl converges to 1 in probability, which implies that Cn alpha converges to 1 as n tends to infinity. Also power at theta belonging to omega K equal to probability under theta lambda x curl less than Cn alpha, and that means under theta belonging to omega K lambda x curl converges to some gamma which is less than 1 in probability, and Cn alpha converges to 1 as n tends to infinity. As a result, probability under theta lambda x curl less than Cn alpha converges to 1 as n tends to infinity for all theta belonging to omega k also. Since power converges to 1 as n tends to infinity, so the LR test is consistent. In this module, we have discussed that though an LRT is widely applicable and is based on maximum likelihood estimation, but it may sometimes perform worse than even a very trivial test. Still, the attraction of application towards an LRT is a very systematic or regular asymptotic distribution of its test statistic, which is nothing but chi-square always. Moreover, a likelihood ratio test is consistent also.